students, in this video I am providing problems on applications of thermal expansion of solids in different models. So please don't skip the video in the middle. Please watch completely up to the end. By this I can assure that you will be able to solve problems easily. Now the solution of this problem. A thin copper of wire of length L increases in length by 1% when heated from 0 degree centigrade to 100 degree centigrade. If a thin copper plate of area 2L into L is heated from 0 degree centigrade to 100 degree centigrade, the percentage increase in the area would be, we have to calculate the percentage increase in the area. So given delta L by L into 100 is equals to 1%. Here copper of wire length L increases in length by 1%. So here we are writing delta L by L into 100 is equals to increase in length 1%. A is equals to area is equals to 2L square. Next, delta A is equals to 2 into 2L into delta L. Delta A by A is equals to 2 into 2L into delta L by 2L square. 2 gets cancels, LL gets cancels, delta A by A is equals to 2 into delta L by L. Given delta L by L is equals to 1%. So increase in area is 2%. The percentage increase in area is 2%. So among this, which is the correct option? Fourth option is correct. In this question, the coefficient of linear expansion of a crystal in one direction is alpha 1 and that in every perpendicular direction is alpha 2. We have to find the coefficient of cubical expansion. For anisotropic crystals, gamma x is equals to alpha x plus alpha y plus alpha z. Alpha x is equals to alpha 1. Here alpha y, alpha z is equals to alpha 2. Substituting these values, gamma x is equals to alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus alpha 2, that is equals to alpha 1 plus 2 alpha 2. So cubical coefficient of cubical expansion is gamma is equals to alpha 1 plus 2 alpha 2. This is the answer. So which one is correct? Third option is correct, alpha 1 plus 2. Given a uniform metal rod is used as bar pendulum. If the room temperature rises by 10 degree centigrade, the period of pendulum will have percentage increase of. So we have to calculate delta T by T into 100 is equals to alpha half alpha delta T into 100, half into what is alpha value, 2 into 10 to the power of minus 6, delta T 10 into 100, 2 gets cancels, 10 to the power of minus 6 into 10 to the power 10 cube, that is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3. So the period of pendulum will have percentage increase of 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So in this, which option is correct? Fourth option is correct. in this question given a thin rod of negligible mass and area of cross section 4 × 10⁻⁶ meter square suspended vertically from one end has a length of 0.5 meters at 100 degree centigrade. The rod is cooled to 0 degree centigrade but prevented from contracting by attaching a mass at the lower end. The energy stored in the rod is equals to, we have to calculate energy stored in the rod. They given mass, negligible mass and area of cross section 4 × 10⁻⁶ meter square, and they given Young's modulus and values of y, alpha and g. So now solution, energy stored in the rod is equals to half into y a e square by l, that is equals to half into y into a. See, this is y, this is into. Formula for e is L alpha delta t whole square by L, that is equals to alpha into y into a into L square alpha square delta t square by L. L, L cancel. Substituting all values in this, 1 by 2 into what is the value of y, 10⁻¹. What is the value of a, 4 × 10⁻⁶. Here L, what is the value of L, 0.5 meters into alpha. 1 × 10⁵, 10⁵ whole square, 10⁻¹ into delta t. Here how much delta t? 100. 100 means 10 square. Whole square means 10⁴. 2 ones, 2 twos. That is equals to 2 × 10⁵15 into 10⁻⁶. Here 0.5 we are writing 1/2 into 1/2. 2 gets cancels. That is equals to 10⁻⁹ or we can write as 1 × 10⁻⁹ joules. So this is the energy stored in the rod, 1 × 10⁻⁹ joules. In this question, they given two metal strips, two thin metal strips, one of brass and the other of iron, are fastened together parallel to each other. Thickness of each strip is 2 millimeter. If the strips are of equal length at 0 degree centigrade, the radius of the arc formed by the metal strip when heated to 80 degree centigrade. Given coefficient of linear expansion of brass is equals to 19 × 10⁻⁶ degree centigrade inverse, and coefficient of linear expansion of steel is equals to 12 × 10⁻⁶ per degree centigrade. Radius of the arc formed by the bimetallic strip is R is equals to D by alpha 1 difference alpha 2 into delta T. thickness of the each strip is 2 mm. This is g millimeters. We are writing into meters. That is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3 by alpha 1 difference alpha 2. Alpha 1 is 19 into 10 to the power of minus 6 and alpha 2 is 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Here 10 to the power of minus 6 taking as common. So 19 minus 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into delta T 80 degree centigrade. So R is equals to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3 by 7 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into 80. That is equals to 2 ones 2 40s. 10 to the power of minus 3 into here 10 to the power of plus 6 by 7 4 28. 10 to the power of minus 3, 10 to the power of 6, that is equals to 10 cubed, that is equals to 1000, 1000 by 280, 0, 0 cancel, 100 by 28, it becomes 3.57 meters. So, the radius of the arc formed by the bimetallic strip when heated to 80 degree centigrade is 3.57 meters. Given a steel scale is correct at 0 degree centigrade, the length of a brass tube measured by it at 4 degree centigrade is 4.5 meters. The correct length of tube at 0 degree centigrade is, the given linear expansion of steel and linear expansion of brass. So, formula is L correct is equals to L measured into 1 plus alpha brass minus alpha steel into delta T. Alpha measured 4.5 into 1 plus, here we are taking common 19 minus 11 of 10 power minus 6. Delta T how much? 40. That is equals to 4.5 into 1 plus 19 minus 11, 8 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into 40. That is equals to 4.5 into 1 plus 8 4 ja 32 into 10 to the power of minus 5. Here that is equal to 4.5 into 1.00032. That is equals to, after doing multiplication, we are getting 4.501 meters. So, in this, which option is correct? Fourth one is correct. Given, find the increase in temperature of aluminum rod if its length is to be increased by 1%. The given alpha for aluminium is equals to 25 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Percentage increase in length is equals to 100. That is equals to 125 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into T2 minus T1 into 100. That is T2 minus T1 is equals to 1 by 25 into 10 to the power of minus 4. That is equals to 10 to the power of 4 by 25. 10 to the power of 4, how much? 10,000 by 25. 25 ones, 25 fours. That is equals to, find the increase in temperature is equals to 400 degree centigrade. Which is correct option? First one is correct. So, increase in temperature of aluminum rod is 400 degree centigrade. Given a steel rod is 3 centimeters in diameter at 25 degree centigrade. A brass ring has an interior diameter of 2.992 centimeters at 25 degree centigrade. At what common temperature will the ring just slide on the rod? Alpha, brass, they given 18 into 10 to the power of minus 6 degree centigrade inverse. Alpha steel is equals to 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6 degree centigrade. Now, D2 is equals to D1 of 1 plus alpha 1 delta T. Another one, D2 dash is equals to D1 dash of 1 plus alpha 2 delta T. Alpha 1 and alpha 2, or the alpha 1 is 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6, and alpha 2 is 18 into 10 to the power of minus 6 degree centigrade inverse. The brass ring slides onto the steel rod when their diameters are equal. So, D2 dash is equals to D1 dash. D2 is equals to D2 dash. So, D2 is equal to D1 dash. D1 of 1 plus alpha 1 delta T is equals to D1 dash of 1 plus alpha T delta T. D1 of 1 plus alpha 1 into T2 minus T1 is equals to D1 dash of 1 plus alpha 2 into T2 minus T1. Substituting D1 and alpha 1, here D1 dash and alpha 2, T2 minus T1 values, then you get 3 of 1 plus 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into T2 minus 25 degrees. That is equals to 2.992 of 1 plus 18 into 10 to the power of minus 6 of T2 minus 25. That is equals to 3 minus 2.992 is equals to T2 minus 25. We are taking common of 2.992 into 18 into 10 to the power of minus 6 minus 3 into 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6. That is equals to 0.008 by here t2 minus 25 is equals to 0.008 by 3. After doing multiplication, 53.85 minus 36. Here we are taking 10^-6 as common. That is equals to, now t2 is equals to 0.008 × 10^6 by 17.856 plus 25, minus 25 going this side, plus 25. After doing calculation, we are getting 448 plus 25, that is equals to 473. So t2 is equal to 473°C. So which option is correct? Given a pendulum clock, give correct time at 20°C at a place where g is equals to 10 m/s². The pendulum consists of a light steel rod connected to a heavy ball. If it is taken to a different place where g is equals to 10.01 m/s², at what temperature the pendulum gives correct time? Solution. For this, L1 by Z1 is equals to L2 by G2. Here L1 by G1 is equals to, the formula for L2 is L1 of 1 plus alpha delta T by G2. L1 L1 cancel. We are writing G2 by G1 is equals to 1 plus alpha delta T. Alpha into T2 minus T1 is equals to G2 by G1 minus 1. T2 minus T1 is equals to, taking LCM, G2 minus G1 by G1 into 1 by alpha. Substituting values of G1, G2 in this, we get T2 minus T1 is equals to 0.01, G2 minus G1, 0.01 by G1, 10^-4, G1 value 10 into 10^-5. 10 × 10^-5, how much? Directly I am writing here 10^-4. So T2 minus T1 value how much? 20°C. That is equals to 0.01 by 10^-4. T2 is equals to 0.01 × 10^4 plus 20. Okay, plus 20. So T2 is equals to, here 0.01 × 10^4 becomes 100. 100 plus 20, how much? 120. So, temperature of the pendulum gives correct time at what temperature means what 120 degree centigrade. In which option is correct? In this fourth option is correct. Given a second pendulum clock having steel wire is calibrated at 20 degree centigrade. When temperature is increased to 30 degree centigrade, then how much time does the clock lose or gain in 1 week? The given linear expansion of steel is equals to 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6 degree centigrade inverse. That is now solution. Delta T by T is equals to half into alpha into delta T into in 1 week, how many days? 7 days. 7 into 86,400. That is equals to substituting values 1 by 2 into alpha value 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Delta T value 30 minus 20, 10 into 7 into 86,400. 2 ones, 2 six. 2 6 are 12, that is equals to 6 7 are 42 into 10 to the power of here 10 to the power minus 6, here 1, here 2, so 10 to the power of minus 3 into 8 6 4, so that is equals to you are getting 36288 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So, the final answer is 36.288. In this, which option is correct? Fourth option is correct. Time, how much time clock lose or gain in 1 week? 36.28 seconds. So, which one is correct? Fourth option is correct.